M-Dog Gaming.
Alright, welcome to Hearthstone M-Dog Gaming. This is a little different here. I'm actually recording this audio on top of a video that I recorded when I wasn't able to record audio at the same time. The stuff that was going on around me, so you may hear a little music in the background that was playing at the time. Although I'll probably just mute the track out for the game. If there's not a way for me to at least maybe just turn it the volume down on it, we'll see what we can do in our movie editing. This was a strange thing here. This was a Druid arena run that I made, and my two kids helped me pick the cards I used, and I helped them a little bit. They were looking at our mana cost, but they're pretty young, so they don't really have any idea about most of this stuff, and so I was pretty skeptical on the deck, and we kind of just did it for fun and did the arena run. Well, this ended up being, at this point, I think we were 8-2. 8-1, 8-2. I think we were 8-2. So this was going for the ninth victory as a Druid. You know, I'd only done it as a warrior one time at this point. I've since done it one other time as a warrior. But I decided to go ahead and just hit record and record this this video. You see the shaman I'm playing, Spirit Turn. He opened up with a totem. So here on turn two, we're considering, should we play Wrath? That doesn't really make sense against a totem. We decided to go ahead and use our special ability, Armor Up, attack his totem, and sort of even swap there in terms of our health and taking the totem off the board. But you'll see a lot of the cards that come up during this match were obviously cards that we had chosen in the draft, and it's really worked out well. This was the first time that I had really not been very content with my starting hand. So, you know, going for that ninth win, that's frustrating. But then the way that the shaman ended up playing it, not having any really good low card hand cards in his hand either, it seemed, I was able to just use my hero ability two times there in a row, and make it all the way to turn four before having to play a card. And of course, wouldn't you know it, turn four, the Drake, top decks, 4-7 because of how many cards I have in my hand. So it really couldn't be much of a better start. And here I am looking, I see those two, he's got two 2-3s, the Spirit Wolves or whatever they are that have taunt on them. So I'm trying to figure out, am I going to Druid a claw here, or am I going to swipe to get rid of one and then attack the other? So this is where this match gets a little interesting. He plays his first of two buffing totems here that ups the attack of what's next to it by the Flame Tongue, gives it +3. So now his Spirit Wolves not only have taunt, but they also have attack. So I'm sitting here thinking, do I want to swipe? I guess I do, I'm not sure. At the end of the day, I think I do end up on turn five here putting out this Druid of the Claw taunt, but let's see. I can't remember for sure. I think I choose the taunt selection. Maybe not. Maybe so. There it is. Bear form. Alright, so there's bear form. I can't take out the totem, so I've got to attack one of the Spirit Wolves. But I know that on turn six, I'm going to have a Starfire available, and I think that's what I was thinking at that moment. But then look at what he plays next. I think this is where he puts another Flame Tongue down. So you're going to end up with a situation where the Flame Tongues are actually buffing each other, which I had just never run into before. He's going to turn his Spirit Wolf into a big attacking machine. If I remember correctly, I don't know for sure. And you see, at this point, getting on the turn six, we actually do have some really good cards in our hand, so making it through those first early two turns was very important. And he is really thinking through this. And there it is, another Flame Tongue. So now we've got a 6-3 Spirit Wolf that started out as an 0-3. And so, I think this is Wrath time. he buffs up one of the totems further. He knows that I can take out that spirit out of his taunt pretty easily. So we're going to take out one of them with Wrath and one to attack the other. I'm actually not sure I did that in the right order. I think I would have had... Now I'm like, whoa! What have I done? The Flame Tongue Totems are working overtime. They're giving plus four attack to that one guy, and I realize that I just want to get it off the table and try to save my minions for as long as I can. But what I didn't take into account is now we have the totems buffing each other. And I really was not anticipating that that was going to happen. But of course, once I take out one of them, it's no longer an issue. The only thing left on that is the buff from the card he played last turn. So now we still... I'm excited about Ancient of War next. We still have a pretty good situation here. He's going to take out our Drake. That we got a lot of mileage out of that Drake back from turn three, I think. Maybe even turn four, I guess. So I am, in fact, going to take out... Oh, I guess he didn't take out our Drake. So I'm going to take out his... basically limit his card draw potential to one by not letting that card stay around. So now our Drake is still 4-1, our taunt's a 4-1, and now we have a new taunt at 5-10, and that gives us a lot of space to do lots of different things. You brought so many to the light, and now you're by yourself. And I think what I'm leaning towards here is using our hero ability to remove that shield, even though it's going to cost us 4 damage. Because then a Starfire will just take it off the battlefield entirely. Now we can attack freely with 13 damage, I guess. So it's kind of an aggressive play. It's gotten us all the way down to 19 health. But we have complete control of the battlefield, and that's actually going to be where he gives up. Forgot this match was this quick, so this is going to be a quick video, but this was, I guess, just wanting to document it. Just had a 9-win Druid arena run. Was very thankful that that happened. It was very fun and surprising, as 9-win runs are these days for me. When they happen, I'm very shocked usually. So we were down to 5 gold and looking at having to pay for our next arena in real money, but I think this probably helped. So we got 2 packs and 210 gold. I think that's the most gold I've gotten on a 9-win. So that's it. I appreciate you watching.
Bye-bye, Nods.
All right, here we are, doing something a little different here, as we are testing this to find an opponent here. We're looking at how this syncs up. We'll say exactly when the opponent is found, and the opponent has been found, right? It's taking forever. Oh, there's the worthy opponent, clicked in. All right. Fade to black, Thrall versus our Druid. I'm clicking in the top left. I'm clicking in the middle for Doomhammer. I must protect the wild. Looking at all the cards. Gonna click on all first two, all three maybe. Nope, just the first two. Now I'm gonna hit confirm. All right, hit confirm. All right.